Hello, we are now going to have a look at how we can represent images in binary. So images can be constructed as a series of pixels that are each represented in binary. I've put the word can at the start of this sentence because actually there are two main ways we can represent images in binary. This whole video only covers one of these two ways. If you want to know the proper words, what we're covering today, where we have pixels, is called a bitmap image, or it's called a raster image, whereas the other type is a vector image, which is not covered at GCSE. So all of this stuff here is just one type of image called a bitmap. But in terms of stuff we do need to know, what is a pixel? Well, a pixel is the smallest identifiable part of an image. We can't zoom in any further. We can't go into a pixel. It's just a block of color. So we've got an image like this. This is a bitmap image. It has millions, most likely, of pixels. If I went in very, very small, I would see this grid of pixels. Now, because this grid is not very small, we can zoom in further and see inside these. But really, if I went really, really close, as I'm sure all of you have done at some point, we can see the individual squares because a pixel is a square and a pixel consists of a single color. That's why we say it's the smallest part because it's just a single color. I can't zoom in any further and see anything else. Now, the important thing to have in our head is that each pixel has its own binary code. This binary code is representing the color of the pixel. Each pixel is the same size, the same shape. The thing which is different is that binary code, which is the color it's representing. So just to give us a really quick example, this image here, I've picked out three random colors. These colors are inside this image somewhere. Well, the JPEG file format or the PNG or whatever the image is will say, oh, this shade of green is 1010 in binary. This shade of gray is 1011 and so on and so on. The actual binary numbers are determined by the image file format and some other settings you might save your image with. Now, resolution is one of the big terms in this topic we have to understand. So another term which is alongside resolution is the image size. We've got to be really, really careful with how we use the word size in computer science because we have a few different sizes. We've got image size. We've also got file size. They're two different things. So the image size is the number of pixels an image has. And this is very, very closely tied to the resolution. Arguably at GCSE, they are essentially interchangeable. So the resolution is a measure of the amount of detail an image is holding. Higher resolution, more detail, which you'll be familiar with YouTube, right? You can watch this video in various different resolutions. The highest one, 4K, is more detailed than the lowest one. And it all links to the number of pixels the image has. Here is a fairly detailed image, which has got what you might call a normal resolution. This happens to be around 3000 by 2000. That's how we would pronounce this, 3000 by 2000. We use a multiply sign or an X between the two typically when representing the image size. The first number shown is almost always the width of your image. This image here has 3000 pixels horizontally. And the second number is typically the height. This one is 2000 pixels high. Now, the reason we use the X, even though we say the word by when pronouncing it, is because really we can multiply the two numbers together to give us the total number of pixels. So these numbers multiplied together gives us around 6.5 million. So this image you're seeing right here is stored on my computer with around 6.5 million pixels, which happens to give us a file size of just over 1 megabyte. But of course, I can adjust my resolution. So I can show you a lower resolution version of the same image. This has the same ratio of width to height. However, I'm using far fewer pixels now, only 200 on the width and just over 100 on the height. This massively, as you can hopefully see on your screen, reduces our quality, but it also reduces our file size. So really common question is, what is the effect of increasing resolution? Well, increasing resolution means I'm storing more pixels, therefore my file size goes up, but a higher resolution leads to a much higher quality image. Another term which is important and is independent of resolution is the color depth, which I found students finding really confusing. Color depth is not the number of colors an image has. I've read that, I've heard it so many times in my career. The color depth is not how many colors we have, it is the number of bits allocated to each pixel. Each pixel is given a binary number. How long is that binary number? So on the face of it, it has nothing to do with colors, by definition. However, The color depth does determine the maximum number of colors that can be used. Higher color depth means I can use more colors in my image. So here is a typical relatively colorful image. Typically, images use around 24 bits as a color depth. And this means I could have up to 17 million different colors represented in my image. Well, why is that? Why is 24 become 17 million? Well, it's because we do our really, really common formula in computer science, 2^24, which gives us how many combinations I can get. It's not equal to, but it's around 17 million. So a lot of colors available to me. This is what most images typically use. And this file size happens to be 2.73 megabytes. What I could do is I could tell my image editing software to cut down on the color depth when saving. Here, I've cut it down to 16 bits. And for some reason, my image editing program has decided to get rid of lots of our pinkish, purple, red colors. We can see that both on the beach huts, but also on the pathway as well. It's now a lot less vivid, this image. The quality has gone down because I've reduced the color depth. Now, this does still give us 2^16 colors available, which is around 65,000. So there would have been space for some purples, but for whatever reason, my program got rid of those. So it does show the impact of cutting down. And I could go even further and reduce it down to only 8 bits per pixel. And this has again cut off most colors now. It's only really the grays and different shades of gray being represented in this particular image. You can see actually my file sizes have barely changed. They have reduced as I've cut down my color depth. Not by a huge amount. That's more because of how clever the compression is rather than the actual impact when it's being stored. But the general rule is if we increase color depth, we increase quality. However, we also increase file size. Please don't forget that it's not the number of colors, but it does give us the number of colors when I do 2^ for color depth. Now, the last time we'll look at in this video is metadata. So metadata is something which is relevant to all files, but we just mostly focus on it in terms of images for whatever reason. So an image file will contain the binary values of each pixel. Every pixel has to have binary determined by the color depth, and how many we have is determined by the resolution. That is our raw image file, just all of those binary values. However, we cannot just store those alone. We also need to include metadata as well. Some metadata is essential, some is optional. We always have metadata stored with all files, but images are important as well. So what is metadata? Metadata is additional information about, in this particular case, the image. So here is another image. If I was to right click on it in Windows, as I've done here, and go to the Details tab under Properties, I can see examples of the metadata being stored alongside all of the binary values each pixel has in this image. You need to have some examples in your head of metadata. And if I scroll down, there are even more examples here. Let me just point out some of the important ones. So some of the essential ones you have to have are things like the file extension. It needs to know the file extension, things like JPEG or PNG, so it knows how to replicate it. This will determine what each color is represented by in binary. It will determine how it should be constructed. It will determine the compression. So that's really important, the file extension. Other essential ones are the dimensions. So this is really the image size. And also the bit depth is what Windows calls the color depth. We need these so that it can reconstruct the binary into the correct dimensions and to make sure each pixel is given the correct color. Some of the more optional ones are things like the date taken and the time taken. Here we've also got some information about what camera was being used and some properties of the camera as well. Other examples of common metadata are things like the GPS location of where you took it, if there is any particular compression being applied. And also the file name itself is an example of metadata that is also pretty important.